Good morning.
Good morning.
You know, I think I'm going to sit with you all, because when I get close to you all, I think I feel better.
Amen.
Because we are all children.
Amen.
Not because I don't like standing up, but I think I like to sit in the table with you, honey. Thank you. I'm going to sit there with me, y'all. If I was taking a light bulb and I dropped and broke it, I wouldn't worry about it. I would just go and get another one, won't we?
Yes.
That has always been true. I heard a story about when Thomas Edison was working to invent this crazy contraption called a light bulb. It took a whole team of men working for 24 hours to put just one light bulb together. The story is told that when Edison's team was finished with one light bulb, he gave it to a young boy, like Jefferson, to carry upstairs. Step by step, he carefully carried it, afraid that he might drop this priceless piece of work. You can probably guess what happened, right? The poor boy dropped the bulb at the top of the step. Jefferson, don't drop. It took a team of men 24 more hours to make another bulb. Can you imagine? Finally, tired and ready for a break, Edison was ready to have his bulb carried upstairs. He gave it to the same young boy who dropped the first one. Now, isn't that trust? That's true forgiveness. Mr. Edison gave the boy another chance. How many chances do we give each other?
Amen.
God offered that same kind of forgiveness. He offered man a second chance and a third. Jesus told a story about a man who owned some land. He planted some grapes on the land and then rented it to some other man to take care of it for him while he was away. When it came time to harvest the crop, the landowner sent some of his servants to collect his share of the harvest. The man who had leased the land beat the man's servant and even killed one of them. God have mercy. They refused to give the landowner what was due him. A second time, the landowner sent his servant to collect what was due to him. Once again, the servant was treated the same way. Finally, the landowner sent his own son to the tenants. He thought surely they would listen to his own son, could you imagine? But when they saw the son, they said, "This is the landowner's son. Let's kill him and take his inheritance." Jesus asked the man, "Listen to this story. What do you think the landowner will do to those men? He will destroy those wicked men and rent his land to someone else who will give him his share of the fruit at harvest time." Answered his listener. In this story that Jesus told, the landowner was God. See? And you never knew when God would step in. God first sent such men such as Noah, Moses, David, and the prophet Isaiah, and others to tell the people of his love for them and to call them to turn from their wicked ways. But many would not. They would not listen. Finally, he sent his own son, Jesus. You know what they did to him, didn't you? That's right. They crucified him. God gave them another chance. They even gave them a second chance and a third, but when they rejected his son, that was their last chance. He is our last chance, too. He is our Savior. That's a powerful story. And in Matthew today, you will hear that reading. Dear Father, we thank you for sending us Jesus, your only Son. Help us to remember that he is our only chance to receive eternal life. So don't depend on your sister, your brother, your father and mother. Always depend on Jesus.
Amen.
Because he is the true light
Amen.
Of the world.
Amen.
Amen. And this was not just for the children, it's for all of us, because we are all children in God's eyesight.